In this video, I show you how to scale down your preview pane so you can edit more efficiently in Shotcut. Hello, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I help you understand open source software. Today, we're going to look at scaling down the preview pane in Shotcut. So for this demonstration, I have already set up a new project and inserted a video clip into the playlist and then dragged it down into the timeline. So at the moment, I don't have any preview scaling on, so this is the maximum quality that I can get in the preview pane at the moment. Now for an 8-second video clip that I'm demonstrating with, that's absolutely fine. However, when you start to get to 20-minute, 50-minute videos, then you're going to start finding issues. You will find that this gets rather laggy and your computer finds it hard to keep everything in its cache memory. So to help with that, what we can do is go up to settings, click onto preview scaling, and then you can scale down the quality as you see fit. Now 720p is just under the HD quality that most people would be filming at. So if you click onto that, you will see the scaled down version in the preview pane. Now that hardly changes because 720p is fairly good quality. But if we go again, go to preview scaling and down to 540, you can see it's starting to degrade slightly. And then when you go to the very lowest, it becomes a bit more obvious again. And down here, we can see when we've got preview scaling on and it tells you at what scale you've got it. Now, this for me is how I have mine. And I would advise if you're having trouble, then also scaling down. Now, it's important to realize that this does not affect your exporting. So it will look a bit blurrier on the preview screen when you're working with it. But when you get to the export stage of actually compiling your video into one, it's not going to affect that. So with that, it means you can edit in the quickest way and the most efficient way. But also when you come to your export, you are not going to have any problems with the quality of your video. So I hope that all makes sense. Please leave a comment if you've got any questions. Consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.